of childhood sex abuse who may have kept it a secret for years out of shame or fear now have the chance to seek justice. A new law in New York called the Child Victims Act goes into effect today. Prosecutors can now bring criminal charges against abusers until a victim turns 28 years old, no matter how long ago abuse happened, meaning right now there is not a statute of limitations. Survivors get 1 year from today to file civil charges. Joining me now from New York, Michael Pollenberg. He's the Vice President of Government Affairs from Safe Horizon, a victim assistant nonprofit. He's also an advocate who helped get the bill passed. Also joining me in New York State, Assembly Member and abuse survivor, Rodnisi Bishott. Thank you both for joining us. I really appreciate it. Michael, I want to start with you. Can you break down what this means for survivors of so much abuse?
Absolutely. This bill is really historic. It's at its heart, it's about statute of limitation reform for survivors of child sex abuse. And it increases the paths to justice for survivors, either through criminal proceedings or in civil court. So it both extends the criminal and civil statute of limitations going forward for survivors of child sex abuse and for survivors who were already outside of the statute, which in New York State means they were older, they were 23 years old or older, and who may not have been able to come forward and make a disclosure earlier in their life. It gives them 1 year starting today to file a civil lawsuit against their abuser or the institution that housed this abuse.
All right, Rodnisi, I want to bring you into the conversation. Obviously, a huge advocate for this bill to be passed. What does this mean for victims who have spent so many years not opening up about the abuse that they suffered?
Well, you know, it means a lot. You know, at the time that I was abused, I was 10 years old, and I was very vulnerable, bed rest from a car accident where I had a pastor who came to my living room and would pray over me. And as soon as I recovered, I was molested by him. And for a very long time, people like me have kept it silent. And it was till when I joined the legislature and we introduced the Child Victim Act, I decided to speak up. And lo and behold, I wasn't the only legislator that stood up and speak up about the experience. I also had Assemblymember Yulene New, Assemblymember Catalina Cruz, as well as Senator Biagi on the other side, who also expressed that they too were a victim of child sex abuse. So for us, it means retribution. It means that now we have a way to seek justice through the court system. And we want to be that voice for all those who's been silent, for all those who felt that they were afraid or that people would not believe them, that now this is the time, no matter how old you are, you have 1 year to file a lawsuit against your abusers, and the institution should be held accountable.
Oh, yeah, it's a ripple effect. I mean, maybe abusers will start to get more and more confidence. Michael, have you seen activity today already? I mean, if I'm not mistaken, we've seen lawsuits filed against the Catholic Church. Mm-hmm. But what does this mean for victims of other abuse, allegedly the ones at the hands of Jeffrey Epstein, perhaps That's even right. the Boy Scouts of America?
That's right. This is not an issue that is unique to any particular faith. You know, there were many institutions that fought this effort in the state for years. And whether abuse takes place in the school, whether it takes place through athletics, whether it takes place through a church or a synagogue, or in the case of Jeffrey Epstein at the hands of a billionaire, it's important that survivors now have an increased path to justice.
And Rodnisi, I want to bring you in because we heard Michael talk about all the different possibilities. Mm-hmm. Is this going to help people, and with your experience, does it help people get closure?
It does help people get closure. You know, one of the things I must point out is that, you know, one out of every five girls are abused and one out of every 20 boys are abused. And so this is something that's been going on for a very long time, prevalent. You know, for me, I represent a large immigrant community. And so we're working with Safe Horizon, making sure that we spread the word in our own languages, in my language in particular, Haitian Creole, so that the immigrant population, especially at the time of xenophobic and anti-immigrant policies that are being rolled out, the immigrant populations can too feel that they can have closure. So we are working hand in hand to making sure that we spread the word, that resources are available for everybody, and that this is an option for them. This is a choice. Whether you choose to pursue a lawsuit or not, at least in all of our hearts, we will know that, you know, a course of legal action can take place if we choose to.
All right. Oh, absolutely. And before, and I'd like you both to answer, before I let you go, do you suspect that we'll start to see these efforts in other states? Michael, you first?
Sure. I mean, there are several other states around the country that have already enacted statute of limitation reform. Until New York passed the Child Victims Act, we actually had some of the worst laws anywhere in the country for survivors of child sex abuse. So now we're in a better place, and my hope is that state after state throughout the country will afford the greatest opportunity to justice for survivors of child sex abuse.
And Rodney, do you think so as well?
I think so too. I mean, I think New York State has been a model for many progressive, revolutionist type of legislation. And, you know, we hope to continue to be that model across the state. So, yes.
Well, we appreciate you both being a model and the state being a model as well. Thank you for joining us, Michael, Rodney. We appreciate it.
Thank you so much.